Okay, welcome. This is the weekend before Super Tuesday?
Super Tuesday.
Is that what they call it?
That's right.
The weekend before Super Tuesday. Welcome to Progressive Discussions, everyone. I'm your host, James P. Madonna of Megalife 21, and I would like, and we are coming to you here from the Newsletter Censored Research Center in northeastern New Jersey. And it is the end of February 2016, and
27th.
It should be very interesting this Super Tuesday, because there's a lot of that means there's a lot of primaries are going on
11.
At the same time.
11.
11 states. No wonder they call it Super Tuesday.
Duh.
I would call it Super Tuesday. Titanic Tuesday, or whatever you want to say. I am here with my co-host and mentor and the founder of Newsletter Censored in 1977, the Reverend Dr. William J. Eisenman. How are you feeling this weekend, sir? That means he's alive.
Barely.
The Rose is Black in Spanish Harlem. Remember that song? And here we have, if you could see it, here we have our evangelical serpent, as in taking up serpents, as in the very constipated looking Ted Cruz when he prays with his lunatic, senile, the Latin version of Pat Robertson, his father, Papa Cruz, is out of his mind. For those of you that have been keeping abreast of what comes out of his mouth, like his son is the second coming of Christ or something.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, you're a real Christian there, he's Mr.
Christian.
Ted Cruz. You don't believe in helping the poor. Let me see. I don't know what kind of Bible you have at home, you and your dad, but If you're a stingy, a greedy Republican that doesn't want to help the poor, I don't see you being a Christian at all.
Mm.
But they profess to be one.
Mm.
You know, and
but he lost a lot of the Christian vote in all those places that they held the primaries when he was supposed to take them on. He lost them to Trumpy. And Trumpy ain't even a Christian, per se.
No, Trump says whatever.
He's just a traditional, you know.
He
goes to church.
Donald Trump just says whatever he wants, whatever comes into his mind. Yeah. The only real devout Christian that talks the talk and walks the walk at the same time is the Jew, Bernie Sanders. You know, I mean. Even the Pope said that. Pope Francis said that. He's the most Christian out of all the U.S. politicians.
The right wing is calling Pope Francis not even a Christian.
No, they're also trying.
I mean, it's true in you know.
They're also trying
in reality,
to trying to destroy his reputation by saying he eats.
They call him a communist.
He eats babies.
A socialist.
Oh, so what?
Like Bernie.
Nothing wrong with that. Communist, well, socialism, let me see. The last time I looked it up in Webster's Dictionary, sounded good to me.
Mm-hmm.
Sounds good to me.
Sounds good to Norway, Denmark, Sweden, Belgium, the Netherlands. It sounds good to like maybe 5-6 more other countries.
Remember when Hillary Clinton told Bernie Sanders in the first or second debate, well, the United States is not Sweden, but Bernie didn't make the right comeback. I would have made an instant comeback and said, oh, okay, the United States is not Sweden. Well, that's obvious because the Scandinavian countries care about their people.
I would have said you're absolutely right.
We're not.
That's the problem.
That's the problem. They care about their people.
Oh,
we just care, the United States, we just care about the rich.
See how they tell the truth once.
But Bernie's got to be more proactively aggressive when he debates Hillary, otherwise Hillary's going to eat him up. Same thing with Trump. Bernie's got to be, He's got to get over that ultra-liberal hipster pacifism.
And they're going to try to dis-Trump, too, at the convention, just like they're going to do with Bernie.
Well, Lindsey Graham says Trump is like a complete embarrassment,
he's
going to destroy the Republican Party.
Good!
Good! That's the best. That'll be better than sex with supermodels.
Jeez.
That'll be better than sex. If the Republican Party was sabotaged by the candidates of 2016, including Trump, that will be like singing Ding Dong, the Witch is Dead. Ding dong, the witch is dead.
Son of a bitch is now dead.
No, actually, that would happen if Bernie got the nomination and Hillary lost. That would be ding dong, the witch is dead. But the Bernie supporters, I believe there's a website that is titled they won't vote for Hillary. No, they will not vote for Hillary. Period. Ever. Ever. Never.
Never. Never. No.
And there are a lot of Bernie supporters that have nothing but contempt for the DNC.
If it's going to pull those dirty tricks like it's, like it's yakking about.
I hear Hillary did not technically really win Nevada.
No, it was basically a tie. She won that, but by throwing the coins.
Don't tell me they flipped the coin in Nevada, too.
She got heads 6 times.
Wait a minute.
This is goddamn fucking lucky.
That was Iowa.
Iowa, excuse me.
Oh.
Not Nevada.
Yeah, I was going to say, I mean, you got to be, Bernie's got to be.
No, Nevada was on Saturday when all the poor bastards, registered voters, that were working in the fucking hotels, the maids making the beds and all this other shit. Come on, that was Nevada. Who the hell votes on Saturday, number one?
So
God forbid we should give them the day off during the week.
So it was kind of rigged that many of the voters couldn't vote.
They couldn't vote.
I'm telling you, man.
His voters.
The DNC, Deborah Wasser Cunt Schitz, her and the carpet munchers, the carpet munching feminists. Well, you got two halves. You got the Democrats who are corporatists that just want to kiss up to the people who give them money, and then you have the feminists that only care about a woman in the White House. So you have them kind of like split. I was shocked. But not totally shocked that Obama tried to make the governor, a Republican governor of Nevada, the next Supreme Court justice.
He has no chance of putting a progressive up.
Sandoval?
Whoever it is.
Yeah, Uncle Tom, a Latin Uncle Tom.
No progressive will ever go through.
So what does that mean?
They say they're going to block everyone.
Yeah, but you know how...
What if he puts up a right winger?
You know,
will they block that?
Yeah, but you know... Well, Mitch McConnell wants to block everybody because he's just that racist. But
he wants the Republicans to win, and therefore that president will be able to choose a right winger.
So he just doesn't want Obama...
That's correct.
A lame duck...
He ain't a lame duck. He's got a 11 months
to
go.
Now, what would happen? What would happen if they complied with the Republican Congress and the Senate and Obama selected a right winger? Well, a right winger would then take the place of the late Antonin Scalia. Or Bernie Sanders gets elected, they'll be bucking heads with a right-wing Supreme Court justice. Yeah. Oh, that's a real smart thing to do.
Yeah, for them.
You just don't want to see...
Citizens United! How do you think they got it through?
Nobody.
It would have never went through if there was a liberal
nobody
on the court.
Because nobody had the balls to oppose it.
You can't oppose 5-4. Four of them did oppose it.
and you want to nominate a conservative Supreme Court justice.
I didn't say that. I said Mitch McConnell will let him through.
All right. Let's.
What the hell does that have to do with me?
Let's carry on. Chisler's Hall of Shame. Oh, by the way, I just want to get it out of the way. Chris Christie, my take, and many others. My take is Chris Christie is sucking up to Donald Trump because he wants to hitch a ride to Donald Trump's magic carpet. And he wants to still be in it, even if it's as a vice presidential running mate or secretary of state. He wants to be in Donald Trump's cabinet, and he'll never fit in any cabinet. But you have two massive levity bells. You have two massive egos and one massive appetite with Chris Christie. So he's just sucking up. So people with egos that big, they don't want to call it quits. They don't want to, accept the fact that they lost. And they lost terribly. Chisler's Hall of Shame. I induct Verizon.
Ugh.
You know, I told you in recent past that Verizon salespeople have been walking up and down our streets and ringing our doorbell, and they're in Walmart, and they surround you like sharks, like salespeople do, and they're very obnoxious and pushy, trying to sell their Verizon Fios package. Now, Verizon Fios, a lot cheaper than my Optimum triple package. It's with tax, it's $130 a month. Instead of the 170, I don't give a fuck what Steve wants. I finish what I have to say.
Finish it. Let him out.
I don't care.
I do.
Because you're not the alpha of your pets.
I don't give a shit about alpha or omega. Let him out.
Ultra liberal.
Don't make a big fucking deal about
ultra
it.
Ultra fucking
just
liberal.
Let him out.
Ultra fucking liberalism.
Now he ain't gonna fucking
go
out.
Go ahead, Steve.
You don't learn that yet, do you?
Well, I don't have to learn. I know that animals are not the boss.
I'm not talking about. I'm talking about you yelling and screaming.
I didn't yell and scream.
Oh no, you were so quiet.
No, it's the way you said. Well, let him out. I don't care. Let him out.
That's correct.
Let him out. Let him out. Let him out. Let him, fuck you. You know what? Fuck you.
Christ almighty. What the
fuck
hell?
Fuck you. And messing up my goddamn pirate flag, too.
Big fucking deal.
I gotta let him out because he wants to go out right away. Oh. Oh, he wants to go out when he wants to go out. So now I forgot what I was saying. Because of some coddled cat. Now, what was I saying? I talked about Chris Christie already. Oh, Verizon. Verizon Fios. Chisler's Hall of Shame. Nothing is planned and rehearsed here, by the way. Oh, also, by the way, I am a moderate progressive that likes to stick to proven facts, and Dr. Bill is a tad bit more to the left of me, so you know.
Yeah.
He has his beliefs.
A tad.
He believes in affirmative action, special treatment for certain groups of lobbying
not what
people,
it is.
And
so please designate it properly. It has nothing to do with that. If you're going to talk about something and talk it down, learn what it is.
What is it?
Don't offer your opinion. And don't look to me to explain it to you. Go study it. Do your homework.
Oh, I will.
Well, good.
It's
been a long time, though.
The only
you've been
thing,
bitching
the,
about it and haven't done the homework.
The only thing I can do is take the take synonymous words connected with ultra-liberalism and look it up in a dictionary. That's the only thing I can think of right now.
I ain't going to
like
do anything.
Like Pollyanna pacifism. You know, like Gary Noe. And,
Gary Noe has nothing to do with that shit. Stop it.
No, Gary Noe.
Stop labeling!
Gary Noe doesn't believe in freedom of speech on his web pages.
He does so. He just doesn't happen to be believing in putting people down. Get it right.
If somebody's corrupt and evil, they deserve to be put down.
On your page.
If somebody's
on your
greedy.
Page, not his page.
If somebody takes a bribe from Monsanto.
On his page. Are you listening to what's coming out of my mouth?
That's being a hypocrite. You're wrong. You're proven wrong. You are. That's being a hypocrite. He talks against Monsanto.
That's his right to do that.
Which I agree.
On his friggin' page, not yours.
But I can't give my critique on Monsanto.
Not on his page.
You know what that's called? Ego.
No, it ain't.
Yes, it is.
It's called understanding your parameters.
Oh, really? Because it's his page.
You're sticking your
tentacles into his
page.
Your page. William J. Eisenman is in control.
That's correct.
You're in control. You know what that is? That's insecurity and not being open-minded to accept all opinions.
That's not what his page is.
So his page his page is like a monologue.
His page is what it is. If you want to be on his page, then obey the rules.
Oh, really? Obey the rules. Like the other groups I was on when...
Do you have rules on your page? If right-wingers come on too strong, what you do to them?
No,
not the crap.
I don't have censorship on my Facebook groups. No, I tell them off.
Oh, really? How many of you knocked off?
Do you see me? I have not booted out. Maybe one person I booted
out. One person.
They quit.
Good. They should.
I don't boot them out because I don't have censorship.
The point is, the whole world does not revolve around P. Madonna.
The whole world doesn't revolve around people who can't handle criticism. Meaning you.
That's not your job.
Your buddy Gary Knoll and others that are like
that. That's not your job on their page. That's your job on your page.
So I can call Oprah Winfrey
anything you want on your page.
A corporate whore on my page.
That's correct.
I could call...
Why is that so hard to understand?
Hillary Clinton, a corporate whore on my page.
Why is that so hard to
understand? You people are Pollyanna, ultra-liberal pussies. You can't handle the word whore. Oh, the word whore is too harsh. The word whore is too harsh. Oh, you can't handle that.
Words.
That's what they are, right?
You say that on your page. Do not say it on his page.
Oh, because... heaven forbid... Any progressive should offend somebody. Oh, heaven forbid. Even if it's the truth and they can't handle the truth. Heaven forbid you should get somebody not to like you.
Why is that stopping you doing that on your page?
Nothing.
Why do you have to do it on someone else's page?
Because the truth is the truth everywhere.
Why do you have to do it?
Because the truth is the truth everywhere. Everywhere. You have to accept the truth just like I do in life.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
No, but are the right wingers accepting?
You know what? In a way, you have a lot of ego in you too, and some insecurities.
Now, where are we talking about ego? We're talking about
No, because you can't handle the proven facts. You can't ever handle the proven truth.
First of all, you were talking about Gary Knoll, not me. I don't give a shit what gets said on my page.
No, you have this thing.
So why are you bringing
where
this shit up?
You don't want to label people at all.
What is that? Because they are no good for determining what is right and wrong. Labels.
They have no.
Labels are for general ideas to be able to quickly
look at things. How do you teach a kid that seems sociopathic right from wrong if you don't show him facts?
You don't do it by facts. Do not smoke like I smoke.
Oh, that's
you
being
do
a,
it by
but then the parent is being a hypocrite.
You do it by example, not by what I say.
Jack O'Lane said
and
that
not
once.
By facts.
He said the best way to teach children is by example. He
it's
happened to be
way.
Right.
It's the only way. What's the best way? You don't teach anybody.
Oh, what about a kid that's spoiled and coddled, getting knuckles across the face?
How did he get there?
The old-fashioned way.
How old is he?
Well, he's not a toddler. He might
How old is he?
He might be in grammar school.
Grammar school. Well, what about those first 5 or 4 or 6 years? What were they teaching them then? so that he ended up to be like you just said he was.
Spoiled and coddled.
There's many years behind being spoiled and coddled, or being sociopathic.
You gotta set an example from day one, of course. That's the logical.
And you gotta give them love.
All we need is love. Wah. Barney the dinosaur. That comes from that. The hipster days where the flower children just want to, oh, please don't dislike Barney me. Love me.
Barney the dinosaur is not a realistic stand-in for a parent who's not there.
I love you.
So it has nothing to do with love.
No, he's like a kumbaya kind of a dopey purple dinosaur, you know.
Who cares? I'm talking about the reality of the situation.
That's what I'm trying to talk about.
He's a cartoon character. He's not a mother who gives love to her child.
No.
Well, why you bring him in?
Because I have to find a pet name for people who need not to offend anyone. Where it's that important for them not to offend somebody. You know, which is part of the far left. Hey, vegans, radical vegans that don't believe in drinking milk or wearing leather shoes.
Offending.
Those are ultra liberal.
They're not afraid of offending. Peter certainly is not afraid.
Well, they're extreme.
So you're
they're extremists. They're extremists.
Well, whatever. But your labeling goes down the tubes.
Well, vegans are.
Can't do it.
Vegans that are extreme animal rights activists have combined the two, and they just happen to want to tell you how to live your life.
There you go. And don't you want to do the same thing?
No, I want what's best
for who?
The population.
For who? For best for you?
No.
Yeah.
You're jealous of old James P. Madonna because that's you know great. That I am well-conditioned athlete and you're not. You've been envious of me for years.
Oh my God!
Getting
you
back
see the personal stuff.
Nah. That's why you always try to twist things with old James P. Madonna. And I taught
how to be something that is not just a bunch of labels. And
I was realistic with some people in the spotlight, but Gary Null didn't like it. Oh, maybe Gary Null's got a little insecurity and ego in him too. The truth is the truth.
And that's what I'm preaching, pal.
If it's a duck, if it walks and sounds like a duck, it's a duck. I don't care if you're a rich Gary Null. I don't care who you are or how much in the spotlight you are. If it's a duck, it's a duck.
You don't believe that.
You can't change the truth.
Ask some independent person to view this a part of the tape. And then ask them if you are correct, and they
if they're an ultra liberal Pollyanna,
no, not labeled,
they'll agree with you.
They'll. I said an independent person.
Or you know there are women who are for Hillary that if you put down Hillary Clinton, they'll call you a misogynist. That is ultra liberal too.
You are doing exactly what you are blaming.
You're playing the race
other people for doing
the gender card or the race card. That's ultra liberalism. I'm a very fair person.
Oh my God!
Mean? Hey, if the shoe fits, buddy boy. You know what I mean? Sometimes you gotta wear it.
Well, what does that have to do with what I just said?
Oh, I'm a meanie because I'm putting. I say Bernie Sanders should be more aggressive in the debates with Hillary Clinton.
I just said you do exactly what you blame the other side for doing. And what does that have to do with me?
Wait, I'm blaming. I am doing what I'm blaming them for doing. I have no censorship on my political group.
Gary Null does.
That a lot of people on Facebook also have huge egos because they're members of the group, but they'll only post on their profile because they think they're going to get discovered. Meanwhile, they have no pizzazz whatsoever. They have no charisma. There's no chance in hell unless they have a relative in entertainment or in on a TV network, they have no. They only Evelyn Pringle has gone, taken the big leap upward. Gary likes her. Me, I bucked heads with the guy. I smack him around if he was in front of me. But you know.
What she all that
she played she
anything?
Played ball. No, me and him bucked heads at one time. She
what
played she played ball with him.
With
so
anything?
Some people that play ball, you know.
What does all of that have to do with anything?
Because I'm talking about people that
you're talking about yourself
are egomaniacal in their own way.
You're
and
talking about yourself.
Jealous of old James P. Madonna.
For
because
what?
I have.
For what?
Well, if you listen, my groups. Are number one. I haven't seen any groups
there's
like mine.
There's a guy on Facebook has 200 million followers.
How did
what
he?
What do you say about that?
On Facebook?
On Facebook.
I want to see it.
On Facebook.
Is he a household? Is he like in a spotlight or anything like that?
No, I don't think so.
Is it about like a simple?
I don't know what it's about. I just heard it the other day.
He's got 200 million.
200 million followers.
Oh, you're talking about the page where you can click like to, and you can follow. He's got 200 million followers.
They probably become friends. I don't know.
Yeah, I'm wondering what subject it is.
It's not a subject. It's him.
It's him?
It's him.
I want to see this guy.
Why don't you go to Facebook and Google it?
This guy is probably...
Ask the question.
Just he's either a Momo or he's an average person. He's probably... You know...
He could be a celebrity. He could be anybody.
I mean, we don't know.
But he's got 200 million followers.
Yeah.
So what does that do to anybody? Where is he going with that?
I don't even know what the guy represents, so we're just guessing here. I mean, I don't know.
It doesn't matter. You're talking about followers. And then followers, if you have a
and
product,
people proactively,
they buy the product.
And people proactively putting things on my one-of-a-kind unique group, and as opposed to putting it on their own profile. That too. As an addition.
Is that their right to do that? Do they have a right to do that?
Well, then why are they members? Why don't they
That's
quit?
That's a question you should
they
ask
should
them.
Quit.
But do they have a right to do that?
They,
Not my question.
They're not... They're, for some reason, they are only putting things... To put things on your profile is to be private. It is not considered a...
Do they have a right
you know
to
what?
Do that?
Fuck them. Basically, they can quit.
Do they have a right to do it? That's my question.
They have a right to be a spectator on the group and not participate?
Yes.
And put everything on their profile?
Yes.
Fuck them.
I'm not asking
I don't,
that question.
They have a right. Well, then have them quit. Why don't you quit,
Why
you
don't
jerk?
You ask them?
You quit. Screw you, too.
Why
this
do
is,
you change
this is the last show.
All the time?
This is the last fucking show. Fuck your newsletter, too.
Oh, whoop-de-doo.
All right.
Oh, that really hurts people.
Like I was
that
saying.
Does something.
Oh, fuck you, jealous fuck.
I ask you a simple question. Do they
have a right? Yeah, they have a right, and I have a right to tell them off.
Fine. Bingo. Now you're learning.
Yeah, now I'm learning.
Oh, whoop-de-doo, you're learning.
Fuck is
now.
All. Quit the group. All of yous. I don't care. I'll still have plenty of people there. I got my following. Believe me, I got my
if
fan.
You have a problem.
I got my fan following. Believe me.
Who cares?
Who cares?
Who the fuck cares about that? I ask
you
a question.
You, Gary, Noe, and the rest of you are weasels next to James P. Madonna. Weasels.
Who cares?
Anyway, getting back.
We are not that insecure.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I noticed you're this insecure, jealous little guy that puts everything on your profile, but never puts anything. But there are a lot of people.
What profile?
There are a lot.
I haven't been in my profile for over a year.
Like, what's his
what
name?
What are you talking about?
Mitch. What is his name? Mitch McClatt?
I don't give a shit
Mitch
about McClatt. Mitch. Or we're talking
there's
about
a whole,
something else.
There's a whole host of people that post things on their profile and never on the group. A whole host of people.
Great. Talk to them. What's the problem?
I post things. Hey, come on, guys. you know, you're posting things only on your profile. That's not publicly being out there. Okay, how many friends do they have on their friends list? Not a lot.
Well,
how many people are in the group? A few thousand. Well, post things on the group. They don't answer. They don't answer. Now, Evelyn Pringle comments occasionally. Jennifer from Nevada, Las Vegas, she comments. She clicks like. But they don't post. All these people never post on the page. Now, on the other hand, on my health group, Holistic Health Talk, I have the most proactive bunch I could ever wish for. They all upload and